Hey, what's up? This is Hondo Solomon coming at you with yet another video on family bonding rituals. This particular one, I'm going to focus on the family crest, the family flag, mission statement, and your mantra. Family crest is very important. You know, a lot of wealthy families have a family crest. In fact, I've only seen this among wealthy families. And generally, they will have it on a ring, and they will have something inscribed on the ring, like a logo, some type of totem. It's like, when I say totem, I mean it's like an animal. A family crest is a type of totem. It don't have nothing to do with demons or anything. I don't want the Christian folk hitting me up saying that I worship demons, okay? A family totem simply is something representing your family lineage and your legacy. For instance, I come from a creative family. My maternal and paternal sides of the family, they're all creatives. They sing, you write songs, they paint, they're inventors. Everyone in my family creates something. And they're also a lot of, many of them are or were, or they're retired from the allied health field. So I had a lot of nurses in my family until they retired. One person was an OR tech. And we got counselors in my family, drug rehab counselors, mental health counselors, you know, but it's mainly a very creative family, something that has to do with bringing your emotions out, right? So that's what my family crest, represents. I'm actually going to get one designed very soon. Whether or not you're married, it doesn't matter. You want to design one. I'm speaking specifically to the men, right? Men, you need to have a family crest so when women join onto your family or you're courting them, they have this thing. Now, when they join your family or if they join your family, they should have a ring. Everyone in your family should have a ring or some type of metal, something to wear around the neck. It might be a bracelet, something. You might get something, a different thing, custom designed for each member of the family. But you always want your family crest on there. Now, family crest can go on a flag also, and that flag can also include the mission statement, include the mantra, which is a song. It can be hummed, it can be sung, it can be spoken. All of that can go on one flag, but you want the same logo also on your ring or on some type of metal that you wear, and or a bracelet. You know, if you're a man or a woman, you may have some type of bracelet. For women, you may have one of your consorts may have an ankle bracelet with something inscribed on them to display your family's lineage. You know, and these family crests actually represent your family's history, and it represents where your family is going. So, family crests are prophetic in scope because it's where the patriarch of the family, who invented that family crest and who started that particular part of the family's culture, because remember, sometimes families shift gears, but if the patriarch of that family's culture has gone in a different direction, then you want a family crest to reflect that. And again, it should reflect where your family's come from, how they were forged, and where they are going. So my family crest, again, will reflect the fact that we are creatives. We're full of people who are songwriters and painters and singers and musicians. I almost joined my family's band one day. We were getting a family band together, and you know, they were going to train me on how to play a particular instrument. I remember my father was a multi-instrumentalist. You know, he could play anything, and he even went to a music conservatory when he was out of high school. So that's what I come from, and now I'm a songwriter. I'm following in my family's footsteps. So this is all part of the bonding rituals of the family, because it keeps you tied together spiritually, emotionally, mentally, and even physically when you get together and you participate in these particular activities. But again, you want to get a nice flag made, preferably of natural materials, linen, cotton, silk. It can be made from wool. You know, it can be made of tree bark. It can be like a piece of bark that's shaved down, a piece of wood, a piece of marble, pumice stone, whatever it is that you choose. But you want to work that out. And again, men, if you have no consort, whether you have one consort or many, you want to design this so that women have something to come home to as it were, and you can get them involved in the family. Shoot, you can create dances off this stuff. I mean, you do what you want to do. You can take it as far and as deep as you want to, okay? But I'm going to have more on this in Polygamy as Economic Warfare, which is volume 2 of the Polygamist Papers series. And I have 4 volumes all together that are coming your way. So volume 2 of the Polygamist Papers series, Polygamy as Economic Warfare, debuts this spring, 2015. And I will be going in hard about family bonding rituals, but I will be including a chapter on food, on taking trips and things of that nature as well. This is Hondo Solomon signing off. Peace.